I've received a report of a strange beast spotted in a river in South Africa. A man was walking along a remote stretch of the Buffeljacks River when he saw what he thought was a woman drowning. He rushed to help, but when he got close, he realized that it wasn't a woman at all. The creature was the size of a human, but it had a pale, shimmering body. He says he found himself rooted to the spot as if hypnotized or under a spell, and the creature made its escape. The report says that the man believes that what he saw was an ancient beast, known in South Africa as the Kaiman. I've heard that a cousin of the Kaiman eyewitness lives here in the town of Sobrak. Her name is Maggie Gentiles. If I can find her, I could be a step closer to getting some answers about what was seen in the river that night.
Hello? Oh, hello. Hello, are you Maggie?
Yes.
I'm Jeremy.
Nice to meet you.
I explained to Maggie how I got her name and my interest in her cousin's story.
In the early January, they're having a braai,
yes,
at a picnic area. All of a sudden, they get aware of the sound that came up out of the waters.
What did they see exactly?
The top part is lady, and then the other half is fish. When she comes up, and she looks at him, it was like the red eye. It was as if that eye attracts him.
Like, yeah, hypnotized or something?
Yes. Some people are talking about a caiman. Other people are calling it a mermaid.
Sightings of mermaids, mythical creatures with the head and upper body of a woman and the tail of a fish, have been reported across the world and throughout history. Mermaids turn up everywhere, from ancient Greek mythology to medieval folklore. Christopher Columbus describes seeing mermaids on his voyage to discover the Americas. And I have investigated freshwater sightings in Guyana in South America. Maggie tells me that in this part of South Africa, belief in mermaids is widespread. And to understand how deeply ingrained it is in the local psyche, there's a place nearby I have to visit.
Here we go. Oh, look at this. Look, look, look. These are animals, four-legged animals. There! Right, so here we go. There's creatures here, there's several of them. They all have a head, arms, and a tail. You don't have to use your imagination. It just leaps out.
These paintings of human-fish hybrids could be 50,000 years old.
I'm now taking in more detail. So they all have a head, two arms, torso, and then a tail, like a fish tail. But there's other things going on. There's a wavy line forming a bit of a semicircle. That could represent the surface of the water. So you've got most of them just under the surface, and then you've got a few that have come through.
What I've often found, looking into stories of water monsters, very rarely does anything come out of nothing. It lends credibility to what I've been hearing lately. It's tantalizing. There is something that is real on a certain level.
The dusky cob, or cabellio, is a man-sized fish, growing up to 6 feet and 150 pounds.
And this is a fish that everybody thinks of as a sea fish, but apparently they are found up the rivers, including the Breda River. This is a river I've actually fished before, so I think it's very clear from this, very clear what I need to do next. I need to go and fish the Breda River.
The Breda River in Western Cape Province is connected to the Buffeljacks, the scene of the mermaid incident I came here to check out. So my investigation has come full circle.
How are the numbers like today compared with, I don't know, 100 years ago, something like that?
They're under quite a bit of pressure. There's a lot of recreational fishermen that catch them. Some of the guys, it's their first big fish ever, and they'll take it home for the mountings or whatever.
They've got those quite big eyes.
at night, if they catch the light, do they reflect back any at all or anything?
Yeah, they nighttime it seems to reflect back red. You get a reddish sheen in their eye.
When she comes up and she looks at him, it was like the red eye.
Eyeshine is only part of the story. Could a dusky cob be mistaken for a half-woman, half-fish with pale, shimmering skin? The only way to know for sure is to catch one. For a long time, nothing happens.
Oh, there you go.
Then finally, a take. And this time, it's big.
Yeah, this is a heavy fish. We have a fish. This feels quite a good size. Might need to come along this side here, swimming upstream. Oh, it's a kick. It's off again. This is going to be an interesting fish, I think. We're in about 15 feet of water. It's going down under the boat. I think it could be quite handy to get the anchor up. I'm starting to worry a little bit now because this fish is on this gear. It's taken a while to come in. There's a risk that the shark will just come and chop it in half, which we don't want. It's going to surface, it's going to surface. There it is. Running again. Leader's in sight. Can you see the fish? Okay. We have it in the boat. Dusky cob. This is what I was after, and it's a good size one.
Dusky cob spend most of their life in the sea, but also migrate into rivers. At just over 5 feet long, this shimmering fish is easily woman-sized. Mark, my guide, has already confirmed that cob have a red reflective layer in their eyes. So have I finally got my hands on the silvery creature behind the mermaid mystery?
So I'm thinking for some of those stories at least where people claim to have seen a supernatural creature, a mermaid, breaking the surface of the river, I actually think this real life, flesh and blood creature was what they saw.